Good morning, Wisconsin. Good morning, world. It's a new day. Thanks for kicking it off with us right here at WFHR, locally grown radio. Got your host, James J. behind the mic. I am joined by our head of news, Melissa K.
Good morning.
And we hope you're having a good start to your day out there, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Good things coming up for you. Of course, we'll have the El Café Birthday and Anniversary Club right around the corner. We're also going to get into, well, maybe we will. Well, we'll see. Well,
are you being indecisive, James?
No, I'm just procrastinating because it's procrastination week and just want to make sure that we're
just
really
putting that off there.
Well, we want to celebrate these holidays, don't we? I mean, I guess,
well,
you know,
later, maybe at the last minute.
Yeah, especially because it's radio. And we only have so much time. We should get moving. we will talk about procrastination week. We'll get into that a little bit in a little bit. We'll also have
a little bit.
Yeah, I don't know what that was.
A little bit later. Yep. Maybe we'll get later to that in a little bit.
I'm so glad you called me out on that. That was so bad. IHOP and Applebee's are up to something. We'll get into that.
Well, they have to be.
Yeah. Driving. How many of us enjoy driving as far as how we get around, bop around and everything? Hmm. What is our favorite way to do that? We'll touch on that.
With our eyes open.
Yes. You're on fire already. We've got that all coming up for you, of course. And it's a Wednesday. Happy Wednesday. Happy hump day, everybody. Whoop, whoop. We'll be joined by our friends from Quality Plus Printing with our Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday. Looking forward to that.
Awesome.
That's going to be fun. 9 o'clock hour. Going to have a bunch of good things in it as well. But I want to actually kick things off with talking about our friends over at Quality Plus Printing.
Okay.
And this fun, new, awesome contest that they have going on.
Yeah.
The Who's Your Hero contest. Who's your hero?
Mm-hmm.
What could be more extraordinary than having a hero in your life, embracing the joy of celebrating the hero in your life with us? Join us in honoring your exceptional hero by featuring them in our prestigious Hero High yearbook. As one of the cool things of this, you're also going to get put on a t-shirt by their friends over there. You can email them. We all know a hero. We all know good people out there. And we know a lot of these people don't get a lot of due. They don't really get the due that they deserve.
They don't get the accolades they deserve.
We are going to be celebrating our local heroes with our friends over at Quality Plus Printing and part of their corporate, their new side, you know, part of things, Wham.
Yep, his little side hustle.
Wham is a fun way of getting your shirts out and getting a lot of apparel, so be sure to look into that and look into the great things that they're doing at Quality Plus Printing. You can email your hero to them at whamincorporated.com. That's whamincorporated.com.
It was with a K, right?
Yes, with a K.
Mm-hmm.
If you need that email, just go ahead and email us. We'll get it to you. or reach out to us. And mm-hmm. Be sure to follow Quality Plus Printing on their social on Facebook. It's a great way to keep up to date on the things they're doing. And be sure to be able to submit your heroes to them.
Yeah.
We've waited too long. We've procrastinated long enough. Let's get into this, Melissa. Okay. National Procrastination Week. We're in the middle of it.
We are in the middle of it, which means you only have a few more days left to procrastinate.
I really meant to bring this up yesterday, but I mean, you know, I procrastinated and, you know.
You had to.
It's how you celebrate
it's
the week.
Requirement.
Should this week ever get here?
Or should it just, we just keep putting it off?
It's just something we talk about doing, but we never actually do.
Never actually do.
You know what? We should have a procrastination week, Melissa. We should do that.
Yeah. You know, eventually. Maybe.
Well,
someday.
What about next month? You know, we shouldn't rush into this. Let's plan it out. What we should do, we should have a couple of meetings. And then, you know, from there, we'll all take vacation. Then we'll come back, have a couple more meetings. And eventually.
Or let's talk about having a meeting.
Yeah,
Let's not ever actually have the meeting.
No.
Meetings, you know, I mean, sometimes they're fun.
if you're wondering why you procrastinate, researchers from Ohio State University just reported on a link between our attitudes and our actions, particularly when we're approaching tasks that we don't want to do. There's a term called valence weight bias, valence weighting bias, which describes how much someone is influenced to act by drawing more on their positive or negative attitudes. The studies were complicated, but basically they found that people were less on the ball about something if they dreaded the idea of it more than they were excited about the positives. So like feeling good about completing your taxes or setting things in motion to get a tax refund.
Okay.
Of course, you can incentivize people to procrastinate less, and the effect is more prominent when people don't think about it. Think about it as a task, and it's less of a factor when people are motivated to think about more about it. This may sound a little unsurprising, and maybe that's because we usually know why we're putting something off, but we still do it anyway. That said, they do note that the valence waiting bias can lead to another kind of procrastination if your attitude is too positive, like putting off studying for a test because you feel confident about it and you got this. Even though
I'm going to pass this, no problem. Yeah, I got this. Yeah, yep.
You don't have it. Study. Study.
Always study.
I don't think that this report, like other things, you know, hey, chocolate is addictive. Okay, we didn't need we understood that already.
You need to drink water. Whoa. Hmm.
Sometimes it is nice to have the data to it. And I do think, too, that it's noteworthy, no matter how corny it sounds. Everybody can relate to this.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody.
Oh, yeah. I think pretty much all of us procrastinate.
If you have never done this before, please call up 715-424-2600. I want to talk to the one person who has never done this.
Never put anything off.
And I do think that there is some there is some empathy there. There is some connection there that shows us how much more we're connected than we're not.
Right.
But what are the biggest things we procrastinate? Like, I'm not saying, like, you know, heavy stuff, like going to the doctor or something like that. I think a lot of people do that. Dad.
you're being targeted there, Jim.
Yeah, yeah. Rightfully so, dang it. But that is one thing. He's not alone there. You know, others do that from time to time. Mm. That yearly checkup or that sore tooth you got that you're just waiting on, you know, to get until it gets really, really bad.
Mm-hmm. Or, you know, like simple things like cleaning out your closet.
Yeah.
You know, like getting that garage cleaned out in the spring.
That's more what
cleaning
I'm talking
about. Cleaning is something
about
that I procrastinate on a lot because I don't like it. I procrastinate.
I get that. I think a lot of people can get that. And let's open this up to the best listeners in radio. We want to hear from all of you as well. What are some simpler or, you know, easier things or maybe that is an intense things that you procrastinate? The laundry, the garbage, these kind of things.
Mm-hmm. Things like your health.
Yeah. I especially doing a job where we work in with the public, you want to, you know, certainly look good. You want to smell all right and everything when you're doing a job like this. So I keep I do my best to, smell good and be at least, I'm never going to look great, but at least looking at presentable. We'll put it that way. How about presentable? Can I cover presentable? Can I at least cover?
Stop it, James. You look fine.
That being said, this is something that's happened to me over the last, I would say, like last year or two, and I don't know what to do about it. Mm-hmm. I love being in water. I'm a true Pisces. I love swimming. Okay. I love being out I love all that stuff. I've been having a hard time, like getting myself to take a shower.
Oh.
Like,
okay.
Like if it's one thing, if I need it, then I'm no problem. I'll make the time. Right. I go ahead and do it. But, you know, there's yeah, hey, I got the time. I probably should wash my hair because my scalp is itchy or something like that. And it's a weekend. It's always on the weekend. It's never when I'm coming into work or it's always when I'm not seeing anybody.
Right.
And I don't know why, because I love water. I love being in the shower.
Yeah,
I like those things.
Shower is work. That's
yes.
Not the same. It's not the same as like going swimming.
Yes.
Or you know, hanging out at the aquatic center.
That's
taking
it.
A shower is work.
That's it. Thank you, Melissa. I knew there was something more to it that I'm not seeing, and
it's
I couldn't quite
like
figure it out.
It's not like bath time when you're a kid.
Yeah, yeah.
You don't get toys in the shower.
You should.
That's something we need to work on.
I almost made the biggest mistake of my radio career and went a little farther with that sentence.
Well,
gonna
yes,
stop
you could.
Right there.
Yep, we probably should.
I will procrastinate on that that horrible joke I was about to make. We do want to hear from you guys, though, because I think that this is, again, this is one of those things that brings us closer together. We have this in common. There are people from other necks of the woods and other walks of life that you look at each other and it's the Spider-Man meme. Oh, you hate doing that, too? Oh, so do I.
We're similar.
But it's all got to get done. That's the other part of it, too. And I there are very few things where I procrastinate them, if only not because I'm great about doing stuff, but because I feel like rip the Band-Aid off. I'm a very rip the Band-Aid off person. Let's just get it over with. Let's get it done. And future me will be happier. You know, I don't think I'm necessarily great about not procrastinating. I think I'm just really, really bad at having things on my to-do list or having things that I need to get done. And I just want to get it done so I can relax or get move on to something more fun or something like that.
Yeah. I mean, sometimes that's getting started is the hardest part.
Yeah.
For me.
Yeah.
It, and that's, you know, like once you get started, you just do it. Then it's easier to accomplish the task. But it's also easy to procrastinate.
Oh, it's so easy.
Well, if there's not a deadline for it and it doesn't absolutely have to be done, well, then it's, you know, it's easy to just push it off.
If procrastination was a sport, we would have a lot of all-stars. We would have a lot of all-stars.
Can we have the procrastination Olympics, please?
Yes, yes. Add that to the Olympics. see how that goes. Oh, there's going to be some people that would be pretty darn good at that, I bet. I wonder,
how entertaining is it going to be to watch, though?
Yeah, yeah. That's not going to be. And we're waiting, and we're waiting. NBC is just, it just has a specific channel just for the procrastination competition.
There we go.
And the
but you know, we do some entertaining things while we're procrastinating.
Yes, that's true.
Right?
Yeah,
it's not
yeah.
like we just sit there and mull on about it. We do other things.
The delegate from Belgium is into his fifth hour of not doing anything.
He's now sorting his stamp collection as opposed to cleaning the table off. How many other things can he do before he cleans off that table?
Oh, it looks like his wife is coming out. Looks like his wife. Oh, no, she's not.
Now he's motivated. Here we come. We've come to the end of procrastination.
We will take a time out. We'll come back and get into some fun stuff with our friends at El Cafe and the Birthday and Anniversary Club right here on WFHR, locally grown radio.
Happy birthday, happy birthday.
Do, do, do. It's time to do some celebrating with the Birthday and Anniversary Club and our friends over at El Cafe.
Yeah.
One of our favorite parts of the day. We love celebrating your birthdays and anniversaries, everybody. Let's talk a little bit about our friends at El Cafe, Melissa. They're at 221 Market Avenue in beautiful Port Edwards. They wish everyone a happy Wednesday. Hope the week is treating you great. They are we are halfway through the week, everybody. Come join them as they keep celebrating Greek foods. They got some a great breakfast special right now, Greek omelet there. lunch special is a gyro wrap or gyro or however you want to pronounce it.
Gyro.
Product.
I say gyro.
The Greek family near us always pronounced a gyro, so that's what I've always said.
And when I was a kid, it was gyro.
Yes, yes. Say it however you'd like over at El Cafe. See the way they say it over there. Ahead and find out. There's no
however you say it. I bet you it's delicious.
Oh, the cucumber sauce on the gyro. So good. So good. So good. Get on over there and enjoy. So Melissa and I can live vicariously through you, everybody.
Yes, please do.
And keep in mind that we collect these names every day and grab qualifiers because at the beginning of every month, thanks to our friends at El Cafe, we're able to give two $20 gift certificates to take on over there and use as you like.
That's awesome. Yeah. All of their specials include a drink.
Yeah, I love that.
I think that's just awesome. You don't have to pay for your drink when you order their special.
It's such a smart move. I really appreciate a lot of those attention to details that they do over there. Yeah, it's a great spot. The only thing better than the price is the food, and the spot is the people. Be sure to go check out our friends at El Cafe. Also, keep in mind that we want your birthdays and anniversaries. Keep them coming, everybody. Get them to us. Send them to info@WFHR.com, james.mailf@civicmedia.us. You can, of course, direct message us on our Facebook pages as well. And they got another way they can get a hold of us, Melissa.
Call up 715 715- 424-2600. I almost said the totally wrong number right there. I was just going to make something up. So maybe it's safer to download the Civic Media app and call us with one button dialing.
Nicely done. it's one of those. It's a Wednesday morning. It's one of those mornings.
It's a Wednesday.
We appreciate you getting us those birthdays and anniversaries, everybody. Keep them coming. Let's go ahead and take a look at our list. Mel, I need a one or a two.
Two.
Well, that works out. That gives us our qualifier. We wish a very happy birthday to Kyle Beckett.
Happy birthday, Kyle.
Enjoy your day, sir. Hope it's a good one for you, Kyle. Mm-hmm. And our qualifier, Melissa Mattis.
Hey, perfect. Melissa, you have the most awesome name.
Yeah, she does. She has a great name. Shout out to our good friend Raquel getting us this name. Thank you so much, Raquel, for that. And a shout out to Melissa. Happy birthday, Melissa.
Happy birthday.
Enjoy your day. Hope it's a great one for you. You're our qualifier. Keep those names coming, everybody, so we can grab more and more qualifiers and continue to celebrate with you and have a complete list in the start of next month.
Yeah.
Let's take a look at our celebrity list here. Tyler, the Creator, is 33. Good rapper, creator. He's a good artist. He's good.
Okay.
I'm trying to think of, like, because he does like animated stuff. He does sketches and comedy, but also is really heavy in the music. It's kind of, he's known for music. So he's a creative. I don't think you could put him in a box and label him, which adds to the name Tyler, the Creator. Boy, here's a blast from the past. Bubba Sparks is 47.
Bubba Sparks.
Wow, I've learned that name in a long time.
I don't even know who that is.
He was a one hit wonder. I believe he was a one hit wonder. I maybe he had more than one hit. I don't know. I apologize to the Bubba Sparks fan base out there. If I can't imagine that's very big. I'm sorry. The big Aristotle, Shaq Diesel, Shaquille O'Neal is 52 today.
Yeah, that's right. 52.
The only man that can give himself a nickname. The only person in my lifetime. He's one of the few people I've ever seen be able to just... There was an interview where Shaq had said, like, a certain play was going to happen, and the play happened. And they immediately go to him, like, wow, Shaq, good call. He's like, Shaq Nostradamus. So just people just started calling him Shaq Nostradamus. Like, one of the funnest, greatest athletes we'll ever see, and not just in basketball, but I think in general. He was a young athlete at LSU, and he was getting a name for himself, and he broke a backboard.
Ooh.
And it was pretty, you know, back then, even now, that doesn't happen very often. And it was pretty crazy and everything. Like, this guy is that big. He's that huge. He tore down the rim. And then he did it again, like, a week later. And it was like, yeah, Shaq broke another rim. Like, it just...
It's just, you know, something that happens.
In a sport with giants, literal giants, Shaquille O'Neal stands out in history. Like, that says a lot right there. And off the field, he is a sheriff. He does a ton for local charities. I think that I heard once something like a 10 or 20% of Shaquille O'Neal's wealth goes to charities and helping out, like, child care and things like that. Does a lot of good. Does a lot of good, Shaq. Connie Britton is 57. Raina James on Nashville. Abby Clark on 911. Good character actor. Connie Britton, good character actor. Does good work. D.L. Hughley is 61. Very funny stand-up comedian. Very smart stand-up comedian. D.L. Hughley's got some very funny, smart comedy.
Okay.
Let's see. Tom Arnold is 65. Wow. Haven't said another blast from the past. Haven't said that name in a while.
Yeah. What was he on?
He was married to Roseanne, and he was a stand-up comedian who started dating and then ended up marrying Roseanne. He showed up on the TV show Roseanne a little bit. They had one of those kind of like the 80s and 90s. We just paid so much attention to relationships, and I could never figure it out, whether it was Sean Penn and Madonna or it was Roseanne and Tom Arnold or whatever. Like, I never cared about that stuff, and I still don't quite get why we worry and care about those things so much. But regardless, that was kind of like his claim to fame.
Well, he was also in True Lies.
Yeah, he did a good job in that.
He was in Big Bully with Rick Moranis.
Yeah, that's right. He had a run there. He had a moment there, I'll say it.
He had a moment.
Kiki D is 77. She definitely had some moments. 1976's Don't Go Breaking My Heart duetting with Elton John is one of them. She also rocked out to I Got the Music in Me and some others. Very unique voice. I like her voice. One of the most unique and interesting directors of all time, Rob Reiner, is 77.
Princess Bride.
Spinal Tap, When Harry Met Sally, A Few Good Men. He was, of course, Meathead and All in the Family. he is a really, really good reader. I have to do this because this really doesn't happen to me very often where I'm around legends. I had a Zoom audition about a month ago, maybe 3 weeks, maybe a month ago, and I did not know that Mr. Reiner was going to be in the meeting.
Ooh.
He does this, though. He is a part of almost every role you see cast. He wants to be a part of it. He wants to make... Hmm. Yeah, that's the person. Yeah, that's the person. And just so... I don't mean this in a bad way, so sporadic. Like, I didn't expect him at his age and you know, didn't expect him, period, to be so animated. He's so animated. He I talk with my hands. I can't say anything without talking with my hands. His whole arms are moving. Like, he, and couldn't have been nicer. Could not have been nicer. Ask me, you know, how I was doing. I started in a monologue, and I'll be honest with everybody, and I really do not like admitting this. My throat caught. And my voice was a little scratchy. So why don't you take a second, have a drink. Go on. There's no pressure here. There's no pressure.
Aww.
What are we doing? There's no pressure here. It's really nice. Really
super nice.
Cool. Yeah, great guy. Didn't get the part.
Well, you know, but, so you got the experience.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
You got to meet Rob Reiner over Zoom, but still cool.
Yeah, very, very, there was three other people in there with me that were auditioning, and all he treated all of us really good. Really nice.
Awesome.
An incredibly talented human being. David Gilmour is 78, Pink Floyd legend, singer, songwriter for Pink Floyd, legend, part of the band. You like Pink Floyd, hard not to like some of enjoy the work of David Gilmour's work, his work. Mm-hmm. Some people no longer with us. Mary Wilson, born in 1944, of the Supremes fame. You don't have the Supremes without Mary.
No.
Ed McMahon, born to this day in 1923. Yes, sir.
Wow.
You are correct, sir. I told, when I was on the Conan show, I told Andy Richter, man, I think you're so good at this, you know, being the co-host and sitting on the sidelines sitting there on the sideline waiting for your moment. And when that moment happens, hitting the mark and getting in and out. You're so good at that, Andy, and all this. He's like, yeah, but then there's Ed McMahon. Like, his respect for Ed McMahon and people in that industry, we kind of make fun of. We have jokes about Ed McMahon, but he was Johnny's right hand. And what it's like, and you know this, you and I know this, Melissa, as hosts, when you tell a joke and there's nothing there, there's no, you yourself even don't feel like laughing, you know, or something like that.
Like, well, that didn't go over as planned.
Ed's laughing. Ed was laughing. Ed laughed at everything. And because he was a good teammate, he was a good partner. Mm-hmm. Who knows if he found any of it funny or not? It didn't matter. He gave you a genuine, he tried, he was there, and he filled the time. And laughter is contagious. So if Ed laughed, the audience started to laugh.
Right.
There was Ed McMahon, one of the greater improvers we've seen. And nobody ever gives him credit for this. But the biggest rule in improv, say yes. Say yes. Go with the flow. Go with it.
Yep. Keep it going forward.
Ed McMahon, everything that Johnny did, he followed along. He pushed. He helped. He helped add to it and everything. You never saw Ed McMahon stumped. You never saw him kind of like, I don't know what to do. Hey, Doc Sullivan, you got anything? Like, no. Ed was incredibly good at what he did. And Ned doesn't really get the credit for it.
Well, and he also served our country in the Marine Corps. Mm-hmm. He was a pilot instructor and test pilot. So, you know, he served this country as well.
Yeah, thank you for mentioning that, Melissa. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And another great tag team partner, Lou Costello of Abbott and Costello, born on this day in 1906, who's on First Fame. Great comedic writer and comedic timing for days. Oh, the comedic timing of Abbott and Costello stands out. It holds up.
Yeah. It's such a well-known and fun bit too that who's on first. I have to shout out a plug to my fellow cast and crew members at our cast party on Sunday. John Young and Jim got up and did a rendition of Who's on First.
Nice.
It was great.
I had to do that once for a class, and the young lady I was doing it with, she did this with me. We had fun. I think we did a pretty fair job at it and everything. Mm-hmm. She had never heard of the bit. Had never heard of it. Just jumped right in. Like, I've been hearing that bit my whole life. I should be able to do that bit. I was really impressed with her. She came in and she got
never
the timing.
Hearing it.
She got the joke right away, you know? And it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun.
That's cool.
And one more here to celebrate. The great, the legend, Michelangelo, born on this day in 1475, passed away in 1564. He was the turtle with, no, Italian Renaissance artist, famous for painting the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel and his sculpture of David, of course. I don't think that there's anybody who ever wanted to get into the game of art and couldn't be, it wasn't influenced by Michelangelo.
Right. Italian sculptor, painter, architect.
One of our greatest
and
creatives.
Poet.
Yes, yeah. And poet. That gets forgotten. Thank you, Melissa, because I didn't even mention that. Yeah, yeah. He was a good poet, too. Definitely one of my big era. Him and Da Vinci, humongous influences for me as a kid.
Well, how could they not be? I mean, the Renaissance art era is pretty big in art history.
Yeah. I did want to mention one other thing. Today is Oreo Day.
Hey.
Yeah.
You don't like Oreos, though, do you?
Oh, no, I do. I do.
You do.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Yep. I remember who doesn't like them.
What I have for the audience here is two things. One, we want to know your favorite cookie. You're on a deserted island. You got one cookie. What is it going to be? 424-2600, 424-2600, let us know. And also keep in mind, our friends over at Quick Trip are offering a free pack of Oreos today.
Really?
Yeah. If you've got their app, or if you get on their newsletter, which I do, you get a coupon, and it's for a free 2.4-ounce package of Oreo cookies. So it's, you know, just a couple cookies,
okay. But still free cookies, man.
Yeah. To me, this kind of stuff is perfect. It's really part of why Quick Trip is so good at what they do. And they are not a sponsor, everybody. Although we welcome them to the team if they would like to. But I do give them credit because you're not going to stop at Quick Trip for this, but you're already
going there.
Yeah, you're already going. Yeah, might as well. Hey, I'll get some free cookies while I'm there. It's pretty cool.
Free cookies.
Yeah.
You know, if I was on a desert island, I don't think I would choose Oreo, though.
No.
Mm-mm. It would be my grandma's homemade cookies.
Oh, perfect choice. Perfect choice. Nicely done. Well done, Melissa. We want to hear what your choice would be. Give us a call, 424-2600. One more time, happy birthday to Kyle Beckett.
Happy birthday, Kyle.
And a happy birthday to Melissa Mathis, our qualifier today.
Congratulations, Melissa. Have a great birthday, and you have an awesome name.
Yeah, yes, you do. Visit our friends over at El Cafe. They're open right now, just waiting for you. Go visit them at 221 Market Avenue in Port Edwards. We'll think of you. We'll live vicariously through you over there. And wish
have a euro for us.
Yeah, and wish them a great day from all of us at WFHR. Welcome back, everyone. Morning show here at WFHR. Definitely no rain's going on right now. It's clear blue skies.
It is. Sun is bright.
Does give me an opportunity to bring up weather and our good friend Brittany. Brittany will be back with us, everybody. Had one of our listeners very worried. is Brittany going to be joining you guys again? Is she going to be with you guys? Yes, she'll be back.
Yes, she will.
Yeah, looking forward to it, too. We're hoping everything's going good for her over what she's got going on and everything.
Oh, yeah.
So we are still going to be joined by our friends from Quality Plus Printing with our Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday. Looking forward to that. That is going to be coming up real soon here. Be sure to join us for that, everybody. Not only going to be a fun conversation, but we'll be able to talk about some of the new cool things that they got going on over there, along with a new contest, new promotion that they're doing. But right
Hero
now,
high.
Yeah, it's awesome. Do you enjoy driving? A new survey found a lot of Americans do, but it's only the third most enjoyable way we get around.
Okay.
1,000 Americans were polled, and here are the 8 modes of transportation and how many people like them. So let's go ahead and get into the list. Before we do you have a favorite way to travel, Melissa? I wish they were a little more specific about this, because I think there's a difference between I got to get to work and I'm going somewhere.
Right.
I'm going on a trip.
Right. Because it's not like we have a lot of options.
Yeah.
I can't ride my bike to work.
I will say, when I lived in the city, that taking the L train was my favorite thing to do. I loved the train, and I think that if I'm going like to another state or cross country or something, I think train would probably be my choice. Just to keep the conversation moving, because I haven't really thought too much about this before.
Yeah, I liked that the times that I have traveled on train was cool. Riding in the subway or the tube in London was really neat. That was back when I was a teenager. A long, long time ago. But I guess if, you know, I like biking. If I could bike everywhere, or even one of those little scooters, I think that would be cool.
You gotta go chow, though, in it. Chow. let's see what everybody else thinks. Let's take a look at this list. Number one in the list was walking. It ranked first. 94% of us find it enjoyable.
Okay.
Riding a bike or scooter comes in at number two, 93%.
Hey. Nice. There we go.
Yeah. Driving a car comes in at 89%. Mm-hmm. Being on a ferry or a boat, 89%.
Cool.
Riding as a passenger in a car, 87%. I find that interesting.
Yeah, I'd rather be a passenger than a driver, just because then I don't have to. Then I can, like, I don't use it as a way to, like, watch the scenery or anything. I knit or crochet or read.
Yeah, yeah. Let's see here. Flying on a plane, 85%. That one.
Okay.
Did you like flying? Do you like flying?
I do. I like flying. I think it's exciting. I've flown a lot, so I still get, you know, that rush every time you take off and land. Mm-hmm. The only thing I don't like is when you get stuck in a holding pattern above an airport waiting to land, and your ears have to pop every time they do that. Mm-hmm. That, you know, okay, the wings are tipping. Here we go. Ooh,
that's rough. I once waited on a tarmac for 4 hours. That was the board. That's the only thing about flying. That and the shoe thing. Taking your shoes off at the airport just sucks. Let's just, like, we'll all do it, and you better do it, and you better not complain when you do it, because it's important that we do. But it doesn't mean we have to, you know, enjoy it necessarily.
It doesn't bother me at all. I don't mind being barefoot.
What was the, I'm just nitpicking. I'm not even, like, that's not something that would keep me from it. I love flying. It's one of my favorite things to do. And I love the word that you use, exciting. I mentioned how much I like being on a train. I don't necessarily find it exciting. It's the movement. It's a calm. That kind of thing. Taking the L train, same thing. Getting on a plane, the whole process is exciting. The whole, everything about it is exciting to me. I enjoy it.
Well, the being able to go on a train, like the train trip I took out west, now that was awe-inspiring, because you get to see the mountains, and you're going through tunnels, and you're going just through amazing landscapes.
Yeah, I love that. That's one of the reasons. See, I've never done anything like that. My my daughter and her husband, they took a trip to down south on train. Mm. It seemed like a lot of fun. Seemed like they really enjoyed it. Let's see here. Flying on a plane is 85%. Being on a train is 84%. Number seven on the list.
Okay.
And then there's riding the bus. 77% of us find at least somewhat enjoyable. That is somewhat enjoyable.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Let's see here. Buses weren't the most hated of those eight, though. They were around 1 in 8 people don't like boats, and we're guessing seasickness might have a little bit to do with that.
Yeah, that would probably have something to do with that.
That's pretty
interesting. Ferries are cool. I mean, if you've ever ridden the ferry, that's over by, like, kind of the Baraboo area. I don't remember exactly where that is, and I can't remember the name of the town, but I've gotten to go on that a couple times, so that was pretty cool.
Yeah, that's a good one. Every Wednesday, we are joined by our friends over at Quality Plus Printing with our Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday. We wish a good morning to our friend Phil Hartley. Phil, good morning.
Hey, good morning, everyone. How's everybody doing?
I'm doing good.
How are you, Phil?
Yeah, good. Ready to take that ferry across the Mersey.
There he is.
Yeah, right on, Phil. Phil, before we get to our Wicked Awesome Word, Melissa and I earlier were talking about this great new promotion that you and Quality Plus and Wham are doing. Let's talk about that a little bit.
Oh, yeah, and I guess some new developments on that.
Ooh.
So we're asking people, Wham, let's call it now, our T-shirt printing company, and we're starting to roll a little bit shortly, and we've been getting some really cool requests and stuff. But we want to honor your hero. That's kind of the theme for Wham is, you know, apparel for the hero in you is our little slogan. And so we thought it'd be really neat for local people, and well, it doesn't have to be local, but local people mostly, I guess, to nominate, you know, somebody that's made a difference in their life whatever it could be, from being kind to doing a really cool deed for them, or just being a role model in whatever way. You know, if they can get us those names, I'm supposed to call you now.
Yeah.
That's what that alarm
is. That was the alarm was? Okay.
Yeah. It's like call James. So if they could get us those, and we'll honor them with a, put them, obviously we'll feature them on AM 1320 with you and the gang there, but, and we give them a free hero t-shirt, for them to wear proudly. And, of course, put it out on social media and every which way we can, to honor them and make them part of the, you know, Hero High class of 24 here. But also, really cool development too, James, that we just found out the other day. I was talking with our friends over at the Raptors, and they about this promotion, and they had seen that we put it online and stuff and talked about it, and they want to be a part of it, and they want they're going to have the hero get a couple free tickets to a Raptors game. Ooh. And also throw the first pitch at a Raptors game.
Whoa.
Oh, cool.
They, you know, for during the summer months, obviously, when the Raptors are playing. So those people, if they can, they want, they'll be able to do that. We'll be able to honor them that way as well. So that's, I thought that was a really neat way to tag it as well. It's just gonna, you know,
yeah.
I'm so happy that, you know, they're so community minded. I'm pretty sure I can talk the River Kings into doing the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, maybe have a hockey, a puck drop, you know.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And honor them at a River Kings game as well, if it happens during the winter. So some of our other local people are chiming in on this and wanting to be a part of it. And I'm so happy for that. So that's really cool.
That's wonderful.
You know, this, if I can be honest with you, Phil, I think this started out as a really fun idea and something kind of, you know, be a fun promotion for us, this, you know, you guys and all of us to do together and highlight some great individuals. This is becoming bigger and bigger, isn't it? Mm-hmm. This is getting bigger.
Yeah.
It's getting bigger. Yeah.
We don't just do things small, do we?
No.
Why go small? Can't
have it
just
be simple.
Big shout out to the to our Raptors. We love our Raptors, and not surprising to hear them jumping on this and being a part of it, Phil. That's awesome. People have a hero in mind, or, you know, it's one of those things, maybe you don't think of it right away, but later in the day you think of it, or maybe you come across somebody that makes you think, that person is always there for me. That person is always amazing. Where can they send this great name, Phil?
Yeah, a couple ways. Let me example, but our email here from WAM is WAM Incorporated, so INKORPORATED, WAM Incorporated, if you can remember that, @gmail.com, WAM Incorporated, or just give us a call and talk to me, you know,
yeah.
I'll write it. If it's easier for you to do that way, just get in touch with me. Just two phone numbers of 423- I'm trying to remember the WAM one. It's WINK.
423-9465.
There it is, right in front of me. I have a wink pen right in front of me. So the 423-9465 or Quality Plus Printings number, 423-7440, and just ask for Phil and tell me the story. I'll write it down. Or talk to James. If somebody gives one to you, write it down and send it to me.
You got it. Definitely.
We're gonna keep it. Choose one randomly of all the of all the people that send in a entry, and then we'll keep them too. So if that person doesn't win this month, they might win the next month. I've already got a couple in, James. So that's
excellent.
Cool.
Excellent. So very good to hear.
The ball's got it rolling already, you know. But we'll take more, please, and get them in, and we'll try to honor some great local people, right?
Yeah.
And have fun doing it.
Get those names to us, everybody. We'll be celebrating and talking about this promotion for a long time. Looking forward to it. Phil, we've made people wait. We've kept you long enough. What is our Wicked Awesome Word of Wednesday?
Wow, this contest makes me have this word, so it's pretty cool. So I owe Father Weller from St. Mary's Parish, also the chaplain at Assumption, for this word, because this was a sermon word that he used this week. And it's not a big word, but it's a cool word. It's zeal. Z-E-A-L, zeal.
Zeal.
Yeah.
You talked about, you know, zeal during the Lenten season here, but
yeah,
having great energy or enthusiasm in pursuit of something, whether it be a cause, an objective, a career, or whatever, to have zeal in your life is to have that spunk you need to make things happen. So I thought, nice. Once I heard him say that, I thought, that'd be a cool word to use.
It's a great word.
What's going on, and with this contest, there's a lot of zeal behind this.
Yeah.
we'll use that word this week.
I feel like it's one of those words we don't use enough, zeal.
No. Yeah.
It's a great word. Great choice, Phil. That's a really good one, man. We need to use that more.
Incorporate that word today.
It gives you energy saying it even. So,
yes.
You know. Mm-hmm. Zeal.
It's a fun word to say. You can't say zeal like just like lazy. You can't.
Straight-faced.
Yeah, straight-faced. Yeah. You got to be able to, you got to put a little pop in circles there.
You lean forward when you say this word.
Yes. Yes. A lean forward word. I like that. That's good.
Yeah.
It's always a good segment with you, Phil. We really, really do appreciate the time with you. One more time again. We're looking for hometown heroes here. We're looking, we want those names. Get them to Phil or us here at WFHR, and we'll get to continue celebrating and join our friends at Quality Plus Printing. You got something in mind that you want to get done, bring it to them. They'll make it happen. They'll figure out a way.
Yeah, bring it on.
Yeah.
Bring it on.
For a challenge.
Zeal. Yeah, have some zeal with your ideas and your things that you bring to Quality Plus.
And this is the house of zeal.
I mean, nicely done. Yes, that's your underlined right there for your business right now, Phil. And keep in mind, you can tell like these promotions. We haven't even been working together for a year, and we've already come up with some great stuff together with Quality Plus and us over here. So think what we can do for us. Think what they can do for you. They are good at this. If you want help, you got an idea, and maybe you just need a little bit of figuring out this or that, join them at Quality Plus. And as they're printing these, getting taken care of your printing needs, maybe they'll have some ideas. Got a lot of great creatives over there.
Yeah, be proud to help you, really. And again, anything we can do to help local businesses, local people, it's a win-win. So bring it on.
Appreciate you, Phil. Thanks a lot for the time. We'll talk again real soon.
You bet. Take care. Have a great day, you guys.
You too.
Have a
zealous day, Phil.
Yeah.
Join our friends at Quality Plus Printing at 3515 A Street South in Wisconsin Rapids. You can give them a call, 715-423-7440, 423-7440. That's a great way to get them those heroes. You can also like their Facebook page and DM them those that way, I would imagine.
I would think so.
Yeah. Be sure to get them those names, everybody. Let's get I can't wait to see who our first one's going to be, who our first hometown hero is going to be.
That's it. I can't wait to see the T-shirt.
Yes, that's going to be awesome. We will check in with our partners, and we'll be back with more fun at WFHR, locally grown radio. Welcome back to the show, everybody. Morning show here at WFHR, locally grown radio. Melissa and James hanging out with you. Big shout out to our friend Phil Hartley and our friends over at Quality Plus Printing. That was a lot of fun. It was a very zealous moment, right? Zealous segment right there. That was a lot of fun right there.
He's filled with zeal.
I'm going to be honest. I have my contact is loose. So I ran to the bathroom real quick, got it in place, and realized, I got this stickiness on my hand. So I was trying to get it off real quick and get back here in time. Mm-hmm. But as I did that, one, as you could tell, I was a second too late. darn it. Don't. I'm going to beat myself up all day about that.
Oh, get over it.
But I have a hoodie on. And, you got the strings for your hoodies.
Mm-hmm.
Does anybody else have this happen where I go and I go to wash my hands and the strings get in the water? Like I just bent
a long string.
I just bent down and I'm just washing my hands and I realized that one of them is in the water and now it's all wet. And it's just the weirdest thing.
Wet hoodie string.
Yeah, it'll dry.
Weird things that happen.
It's these things that we like do to ourselves that you feel like you're like I'm smarter than this. I should know how to outmaneuver this. I should know how to figure this. Nope, got a wet string. Never mind.
Better than a wet sock.
Very true. Nothing worse than a wet sock. Can't stand it. Stand it. Mm-mm. Like top five biggest annoyances to me. Wet socks. Definitely.
Yeah, agree.
A top five annoyance for some people out there are these mergers that are happening. There's a lot of merging going on in the world right now. You've got a lot of companies. This, what I think of is that book when we were kids with the fish and then it eats another fish and then the bigger fish comes and eats another one and another one. That's business nowadays. There's these jokes about the utopian future where everything's owned by one company. And I think most of us used to see that kind of stuff and laugh at it or just think that was some, bizarre idea. I don't think that's going to happen, mind you, because of greed. You know, no company is going to be, you know, let another company take them over completely. Say there was two companies left in the whole world, that the egos got them there. One of them is not going to budge. But regardless, we are getting more and more into this realm where you've got businesses like Amazon buying the Washington Post, things like that. You know, you have those kind of things happening.
We have the illusion of choice, but a lot of companies are owned by the same overarching company.
I think knowing those things is just as important as knowing who's in a politician's
pocket.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So these are things to keep in mind. And then there are things like this where I don't know if this could be really good, this could be really weird or bad, who knows? If you haven't, if you can't choose between IHOP and Applebee's, got good news for you.
You probably don't have to choose.
Yep. For the past 5 years, they've been owned by the same parent company, and the CEO says they're going to be creating dual-branded locations soon.
All right.
The idea
one building, two restaurants.
Yeah. The idea is that you'd have separate entrances and seated areas, but the same building, kitchen, and staff. And the seating areas could be blended so that at breakfast, when there are more IHOP customers, they could spill over into the Applebee's area and vice versa. How about the employees? How about the people working in the kitchen that are working
have two menus to have to build? Yeah.
Yeah. And have two sets of customers. If everything's going right and both businesses are busy, you're going to have one wait staff and one, like,
because IHOP's open like all day, right?
Yeah, some of them are. Yeah. It doesn't sound like they're changing the name, so it won't be IHOPies or Apple Hop. they have had a test restaurant in Mexico, and it's just called Applebee's IHOP. So missing a lot of creative opportunities here. Since the kitchens are the same, it sounds like you'd be able to order from either restaurant, meaning the combined menu would be huge.
Yikes.
Yeah. How many chefs are going to, you know, like, I mean, that is a lot to put on your one staff. If you got two staffs, I got no issue with this. But that, I can't, like, as a consumer, I love IHOP, okay? I'm a big IHOP fan. Love IHOP.
Yeah, when you go to IHOP, you're going there for the breakfast, pancakes.
If I'm going there, though, if I'm going to an IHOP, and I have to choose between a regular old IHOP and an IHOP attached to an Applebee's, I'm going to the regular IHOP. I can't guarantee, it's nothing against the employees by any means. It's just, you know, they're going to be more overworked. And I don't know if they're going to know the menu as well as somebody who all they have to do is focus on an IHOP menu.
Well, and the kind of sad reality about a giant menu like that, most of those things are already prepared. Like, you've got frozen, you're getting TV dinners, basically.
Yeah, that's a great way to put it. Yeah, yeah, you're so right. That's a perfect way to put it, yes. And I think we understand that. I think a lot of us know that. But when it comes to these mergers, like Taco Bell and KFC have done this for decades. They've had their locations in the same building and that. And when you go there, there are certain things that you can get it at Taco Bell or KFC, but you can't get it at a merged one.
Because their menus are slightly different or smaller.
It's going to be interesting.
So that everything fits on the order board.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting to see how they do that. But that's also, I mean, those are like fast food spots. These are restaurants, fast food.
Yeah, well, but I think that people, at least I, have a different expectation from a chain restaurant than I do from a mom and pop, you know, like hometown restaurant.
Yeah.
I expect better food at a hometown restaurant than what you get at one of these chain places.
Right. Yeah, I agree.
They're like one tiny step above a fast food place, sadly.
Yeah. I will say, you know, those chefs and those that wait staff and everything working at two restaurants, better pay them for two restaurants.
Yeah, right.
They won't, but they should. No, they won't. They won't at all. No, they won't.
We want more, and we're going to pay you less. That's the way it works.
Yeah, that shouldn't be, but becoming more and more of the business American way. Not something we agree with. We got good stuff coming up for you in the next hour. Stick around. Great things coming up with Melissa and James right here at WFHR.